Hi, I'm Andrew Rowland. I'm the designer of Napoleon's Imperium, the new Compass board game coming to you very soon. This is a Napoleonic-based board game that took approximately 28 years to design, originally coming from a tabletop version with all 3D figures, a square version first, followed by a round pine version with little consoles designed around the edges, around 1,200 figures, and then going to a full Tasmanian oak table with brass ridge drawers, all the works, a very deluxe furniture piece in which I collected figures from all around the world, including designing my own range of metal figures to fit the table, hand-carved ships, etc. A real work of art for about a good 28 years. Approximately 4 years ago, decided to have a go at redesigning it into a board game, something I've toyed with before with another games company back in the late 90s, but didn't follow through. I actually put the whole game back into storage for a while, brought it back out, and now it's been taken up by Compass, which I'm really pleased about. They have showed a lot of faith, and I'm really happy that I can bring something that is exciting and quite deluxe in a huge Napoleonic board game through to Compass. So, for the board game, we looked at the design. It was really important to bring the feel of the tabletop game into the board game. That's what we really tried to bring it in. We had a test team that's been playing it for the last three or so years, Team Napoleon, which has been assisting me play testing the game over and over so we could bring it down to a workable and fast moving with great mechanics into something that everyone will enjoy. And it's the type of thing that's a kind of entry level into serious war gaming. It's not as comprehensive as some of your bigger base games with down to every little campaign and battle, but it is a fast moving game in which if you would have a game of around 6 hours, you'd probably go play around 80 to 100 battles, which is quite comprehensive. There are numerous scenarios. The opening scenario of the game, as you'll see the video is moving through some of the counters. You'll see that there are actual figures that we've incorporated in the counter from the original tabletop game. I really wanted to give it that feel. And having played the tabletop game now with the test team, they would say to you, it does have that same feel, which is great. And that, so you'll see some of the mechanics and the actual figures from the tabletop game into the board game. It's a very large counter set. So you've got a large counter set, large battle cards, 20 cards to every nation, 8 nations, reference cards. It's very large components to this set. So this is a monster game, but the mechanics are very easy to pick up. The type of game that you'll pick up with your son, you'll pick up with people that aren't really into the full mechanics of the game. You don't need to know anything about history to play this game because history will come out through the battle cards, through the components, and through the strengths, the weaknesses, the economies of the different nations that you play. So it's something that people will naturally play. I've had people say they dream about this game afterwards. So I really hope you enjoy it. I hope you take it on board. There'll be new components coming later. Any game with 28 years development means there's been a lot of influential people along the way. So please look at the game credits in the rulebook, where I pay tribute to a lot of these people. In addition to that, I just want to make a special acknowledgement to Compass Games for their continued faith in game designers around the US and around the world, and which is a great tribute to their success. I'd also like to thank Harry Rowland, no relation, but we call each other cousin, of the Australian Design Group for his inspiration and support over the last couple of years that's brought about this opportunity. I'd like to thank very much my graphic designer, Vlad Stanescu. Vlad has been awesome over the last 4 years in his game graphic design, and you're all going to benefit from that. Peter Cross in 1992, who started me on my Napoleonic journey. Thanks, Pete. and the Team Napoleon Test Team members. Special thanks to Daryl Kane and Guy Wernhard. Guy, also my editor, thank you so much. And my family who have been on this journey for 28 years. Thanks, everyone.